Hello and welcome to this Design Cuts video tutorial on using effects in Illustrator. As always in these video tutorials, I'm going to be using an element from a Design Cuts collection. And today this element is from our free watercolor, floral and birthday party vectors pack. And I'm using the cake from this pack. I just opened the Illustrator file in the pack and copied and pasted the cake into a brand new document. And so we're working on it here. Now this cake comes as a grouped object, so I'm just selecting over the object and I'm going to apply a gradient fill to it so that we have something interesting to work with. Now I've already found a fill I want to use, it's the pastel multicolor fill. I'm just going to make my gradient run at minus 90 degrees so that I get this nice color effect. Now this gradient is from a collection that ships with Illustrator. You can find that by opening up the flyout menu on the swatches panel, choose open swatch library, go to gradients, and it's one of the pastel gradients. So with my shape now filled with my gradient, let's go and have a look at some of the effects that we can use in Illustrator. And they're here on the effect menu, and we're going to be using some of the stylize effects. We're going to start with inner glow. Now, when you apply one of these glows, you need to match the mode, the blend mode of the glow with the color that you're using. If you're using screen, then you'll need a lighter sort of color, and white is a good color, but you could also go and select something a little bit different. I'm going to select a sort of pink color here for my glow. I'm going to turn preview on so I can actually see my glow effect. And you can see that it's inside the shape and it's sort of pushing the colors in an interesting way. Now you can make it apply in the center or you can push it to the edge. The inner glow has these two options and you can choose the one you like best. You can increase the opacity. 0 is fully transparent, 100% is fully opaque. And you can also increase or decrease the blur to push the effect closer to the edges of the image. And the ideal number of pixels for your blur is really going to depend on how large your image is. For a smaller image, you may want 1 or 2 pixels. For a larger image, you may want to go larger. So I'll click OK. In the appearance panel, when we have the shape selected here, we can see what it looks like before and after we apply the inner glow. So it's an interesting effect which gives it a sort of almost watercolory sort of appearance, and it's all done with just an inner glow and a gradient. So with my shape selected, I'm actually going to turn the inner glow off for now and let's have a look at an outer glow. I'll choose effect stylize and then outer glow. Now my outer glow is set to screen blend mode, so that's a sort of lightning effect and that's a good one for a glow. I've also got it set to a yellow color, but I could choose whatever color I like. So I might like to apply a light blue glow and that will make the blue glow effect. Opacity again, 0 is fully transparent, 100% would be fully opaque, 75 is a nice sort of setting. And the blur, well, you can push the blur out and that's going to make the glow a lot wider. If you bring the blur value in, it's going to bring the blur very, very close to the outside edges of your shape. So I'll just click OK. And let's go and put the inner glow back in as well. And so this is the combined look of both those glows on our shape. Let's just select over the shape. Let's turn both of these off for now and let's have a look at a drop shadow. Again, effect, stylize, and we're going to choose drop shadow. Now drop shadows or shadows of any sort are generally done with a sort of dark color. You could use black, but you could also set it to a sort of neutral gray. That might give you a softer sort of shadow. Multiply is a good option to use because shadows are normally darker. You don't want it to interact with something underneath and lighten it. So I would always suggest something like multiply is a good safe option for your drop shadows. The offset is how far the shadow is pushed. So at the moment it's being pushed 7 pixels in a horizontal direction and 7 pixels in a vertical direction. If you wanted to place your shadow in the opposite direction, then you could set it to say -7. So we're just going to drop this down to -7, which is pushing it back this direction horizontally, and then -7 on the Y axis, which is pushing it up. And so you're getting a shadow that's in completely the opposite direction than the previous one. And in the case of a drop shadow, the blur is going to have an effect on the softness of the edge here. If we bring the blur down in value, then the edge is going to become really, really harsh. The distance is being provided by these offsets, but the harshness of the shadow is provided by the blur. So if you want a less harsh shadow, you're just going to wind the blur up a little bit. We'll click OK. Now let's go and turn the other settings back on because there's something I want to show you in terms of the ordering of these options. So if I take the drop shadow and drop it above the inner glow and the outer glow, you could end up with an effect like this. So the ordering of these effects is really, really important. So if you get something that doesn't look the way you want it to look, think about reordering these elements within the appearance panel because the order of the elements has a really big impact on what the effect actually looks like in result. Now I'm going to select back over this shape and I'm actually going to remove all of these effects. So I'm just selecting them and dragging them onto the trash can because I want to have a look at another effect. I want to have a look at the scribble effect, which is also in these stylize options. So I'm just going to click to apply the scribble effect, and the scribble effect does just what it suggests and it gives the image a sort of scribble-like look. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start finessing this a little bit, reduce the size of the stroke width. I'm going to reduce the sort of curviness a bit. I'm going to decrease the spacing. I'm just going to reduce the path overlap as well. So I've got something I quite like here, so I'll click OK. Now at this point I might look at my shape and think it might look a little bit better if it had a stroke on it that would sort of contain some of these scribble elements. So I'm going to click on the stroke and I'm going to add a black stroke to my image. And straight away you can see that we've got some significant problems with this effect. What's happening is that the scribble effect is being applied not only to the fill but also to the stroke. With the shape selected, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to trash the scribble effect. Just going to take the image back to its gradient fill and its stroke. Now I want to adjust the stroke a little bit, so I'll go to Window and then Stroke. I'm just going to dial down my stroke just a little bit to about 0.5. I'm quite liking that effect. Let's reselect the shape. This time let's double click on Contents and let's go to the fill, because what we want to do is to add the scribble effect to the fill but not to the stroke. And these effects that we're creating inside Illustrator can be limited in scope if you pre-select what it is that you want to apply the effect to. And in this case, it's the fill. So let's go back to Effect and then Stylize and then Scribble. And here now we've got that same scribble effect appearing inside our image, but it's affecting only the fill and not the stroke. So just be aware when something happens that you don't expect to happen, that sometimes just applying these effects to a limited portion of the image, either the fill or the stroke, will change it to look the way you wanted it to look. I hope that you've enjoyed learning these Illustrator effect techniques. Let us know what you think in the comments below and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed the tutorial. Until next time, I'm Helen Bradley for Design Cuts.